Hello, I'm Claudius, application scientist at Zurich Instruments. This video is about the PID and PLL upgrade options, which are available for all Zurich Instruments lock-in amplifiers. Let's jump right into it and open the PID and PLL tab in the Lab 1 user interface. For each PID controller, you can pick from a wide variety of inputs and outputs to address a lot of different applications. For example, frequency tracking in MEMS and SPM, or stabilization of lasers, and many more. All parameters, like the different gains, can be adjusted manually here. Or more convenient, you use the PID Advisor to set up your feedback loop. Just choose the suitable model, enter the parameters of your device and test, which you can characterize with the Lab 1 sweeper tool. Based on that, the advisor will provide a suitable set of PID parameters for your desired closed-loop bandwidth. The calculated values are displayed along with confidence indicators and the transfer function or step response. All that's left to do is sending the settings to the controller and enable it. After having an initial feedback loop set up, further optimization may be needed. Plotting the PID error and its distribution is a great tool to monitor the changes. Because tweaking manually may be a tedious and time-consuming task, we provide an automated tuner that performs an optimization routine to minimize the residual error without losing the log. To check the controller's temporal performance, the setpoint toggling allows you to analyze its step response, captured, for example, with the data acquisition module. If you need to prevent damage to the device in the loop, or you risk losing its control, you can limit the range of output values. In the same way, you can restrict the frequency range of a phase lock loop. This keeps the PLL on one resonance, even if several are close by, and no frequency jump can occur. In many PLL applications, a limitation is the available control range of plus minus pi. Enabling phase unwrap extends it by 3 orders of magnitude to plus minus 1024 times pi and allows the control loop to follow changes which would be beyond its capabilities otherwise. This is particularly important for applications such as frequency control and stabilization of fast laser systems. In order to make the D-gain accessible for practical use and speed up the response time, apply this low-pass filter and limit the gain at higher frequencies. In summary, the PID options come with 4 independent PID controllers for various input-output configurations. They contain a unique set of features like the phase unwrap and the D-gain bandwidth filters. And on top, they provide the 2 invaluable tools, PID Advisor and Autotuner. Curious and wondering if your requirements can be met? Contact us and let's discuss your application. Thank you for watching.